yoga part one. Excited to stretch out those abs, because dear Lord.
Wow. All right. 20 second calf. Low lunge. Beautiful. And don't push past of what it allows you. And if you need to pull forward, make sure you adjust so that your knee doesn't surpass the taves. Stretch.
Ooh, that was my knee.
It echoed the room. Oh, time machine. Very gently switch legs. Very gently. Now it's twisted lunge. And switch back to the other side. Mm-hmm. And again, if it's too much, just go back to the low lunge or do the pulses. Very slowly, and switch.
Oh, I think I said I want to do the shoes off.
Yes, you did say that. Next. Or we can do that second round. That way we can decide whether we like it with shoes off or on, eh?
After I was already lunged was
so we're going good. Into a modified mermaid pose. So we start off with downward dog. Okay. Lift leg up and then through. We'll start with the you want left leg or right leg?
Right.
Dog, lift leg and shoot it through.
Oh yeah.
Just that
move alone.
Feels good. And then when you're ready, after you've adjusted, leg up, and then your foot. If you can, try to grab it from the inside of your foot.
No, can't even get my heel.
It's okay. You're very tight.
I know I'm tight.
As we came into it, next foot left, shoot out, through and down. And after you are ready and positioned yourself, lift your foot up. Oh yeah, that's an incredible stretch. Don't you think? You got this, girl. That's still a success.
Got my foot up.
I think that's the beauty of yoga. You're allowed to listen to your body, and you're supposed to really focus in on it, you know?
Yeah.
Really listen to it. And you never push past your boundaries. But you can always push to them, you know? Okay. Using a bit of child pose. Oh, I didn't know that crap on that one. All right. Next is the Sphinx. Now, this is just to help you. You shouldn't be putting pressure. Make sure abs are engaged and butt is engaged so you're not hurting your back.
It's making my feet come off the floor. Squeezing my butt.
And release. And relax. Oh, that feels nice.
It's pounding, but in a good rhythm. It's good.
Ready? So next is low cobra. So with your abs, you're gonna pull up, okay? Just like the Sphinx, you're holding yourself up. This is just to guide you. Alright, regular cobra. And lift. Again, you're using mostly abs.
Hopefully get my glasses soon.
Ooh.
Should be arriving any day now. I'm so excited.
I can see! It's a miracle!
See. No more blurs.
I can see distance up until like here.
Uh-huh.
My eyes start crossing a little bit.
I can see
so much reading.
I can see up close. I can't see far away.
So we have opposite problem.
Yeah. So you will always be able to see far and I will always be able to see near.
Yeah.
Perfect for the yin and the yang.
Yes, darling.
My eyesight.
I do the driving, you do the cooking,
yes.
So I don't cut off my finger.
So,
A, Cobra with a twist.
Oh, I like this one.
This one's fun.
Engage, twisting to the right. Hello.
Hello.
Everyone's head, you're lovely. I want to kiss you. I remember doing this at the beach, but with both feet. Pretend to be Ariel.
Mermaid pose.
It was all the Little Mermaid when I was growing up. She's the best.
And slowly down.
Ah, nice.
I was all about Princess Aurora when I was little. Loved her. I loved the idea of living with fairies.
But they didn't use their magic, though.
It was so cool. There were just these cute little, like, grandmas, basically, yeah, bickering. It was so adorable.
Make it
I loved
pink.
It. Get to live in this cute little cottage. She got to go pick wild berries and hang out with all the animals.
And sing in the forest.
Sing in the forest.
I love that movie.
I enjoyed it.
I was a big fan.
Really?
Yeah. Although I like the idea of a princess who, like, goes and gets what she wants. Now, because Aurora was amazing, but she kind of slept through all the action. Like, I think that's why I like Rapunzel and Brave. The two new ones are, like, I guess they're not even the newest ones. Wow, I didn't do it that whole time. I'll catch up with you. I was talking. I got stuck in my head. Does that happen to anyone else?
Okay, it means I get a little extra back break while you're resting. We got puppy, downward facing puppy next.
I'm ready, how you are.
So,
you're gonna go straight into child's pose.
Oh, and you're gonna do a little bit of a wider stance than normal. And then you're gonna slowly push your body forward. Oh, I can almost put my chin or my chest down. Progress!
Beautiful.
And pull yourself slowly back. In the child's pose. And then it's going to be downward puppy straight leg. And you get it. So position yourself first. And then slowly move your legs to straight. And, you know, travel like me.
Let's race.
Downward facing dog, straight leg travel.
Or heel!
It's very rare. And good.
Call this the Peter Pan.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar.
Yeah.
Something through that open door. I believe I can fly.
I can fly.
I believe I can fly.
I can fly. I believe.
Definitely more than 20 seconds, but hey.
Sorry.
Bonus. All right. Rest for a bit and then King Cobra.
And then we can do the set all over again.
Yes, lovely.
I believe.
I think that's from.
Space Jam.
I know Space Jam. I know. Is it like R. Kelly did it? who actually,
sorry,
sang it.
But we love it.
We love that song. It's awesome.
No, but
inspirational song.
Jim Carrey sang it.
Oh, did he really?
In I think it was from Dick and Jane, where he's going in the elevator up to like the top floor.
Was he really?
Yeah, and he's in the elevator going, I believe, I believe, I believe.
All right, and then both like,
ready for round two?
Yes.
They fixed the clock, did they?